Hi everyone, I am jdcviolin, and in today's video we're going to be learning about all of the settings for the audio source inside of Unity Game Engine. So let's go. First off, we need to distinguish between an audio listener and an audio source. So the audio listener is basically your ears. Imagine that you're in the game and your ears are the audio listener. The audio source, on the other hand, acts sort of like a speaker. So imagine that you have a big boombox inside the game and that boombox is playing music. That would be an audio source. The boombox itself would be transmitting the audio. So you have an audio source, which is located right here. So we put an audio source inside this game object. And today what we're gonna be doing is looking at all of these settings and these ones down here. And this is very important because if you want your music to sound the way you want it to, then you need to know what all of these do. First off, where is the player? The player is right here. I am standing in the place that the player would start the game, and I'm gonna preview the audio without playing the game. So here we have a sort of ambient sound, and let's turn it off. Let's start by going over these up here. So here you can change the sound that is playing by opening up this window, where you can select another audio clip, but we're gonna keep the one we have for now. Here where it says output is where you're gonna choose where to route the audio. Where do you want it to come from? Because you have an audio mixer, which is located over here, and that mixer is gonna have all of the channels with all of the audio in your game. So maybe you want the sound to be coming from here. You can do that from here. You can just click it and choose where in the mixer you're gonna route the audio. So down here we have these tick boxes. You have mute, which is pretty self-explanatory. You just mute the audio and now it's not playing. If I unmute it, you can hear it again. Bypass effects. So this one eliminates the effects that you have on the audio source. So it's very important that you understand that the effects have to be in the audio source itself for you to be able to bypass them. It doesn't bypass effects that are in the mixer. So you need to have the effects inside the audio source to be able to bypass them with this tick box. Bypass listener effects bypasses every effect that is on the audio listener, which is separate from the source. Bypass reverb zones. So this one refers to the reverb zones that you can apply to audio in Unity. And if you want to bypass them, you can just tick the box right here. Very handy. Play and awake. This one's very important to have it ticked on if it's music, because you want it to play as soon as the game starts, right? So check out what happens if I don't tick it. The audio is not going to play unless I have a script that tells me to play the audio when a certain situation happens. But if I wanted to play it right away when the game starts, just tick that. If you want the audio to loop continuously, just tick on loop. Let's go down here to these sliders. So this one is priority. Imagine that you have a huge game and you have a lot of audio happening at the same time. You have explosions, you have footsteps, you have people screaming, you have gunshots, and you have music on top of that. You want every sound to have a priority because sometimes the game engine won't be able to play all of them at once. You want to make sure that some of them are higher in the priority because you want them to play. For example, music. You want music to play all the time. So definitely have a high priority for music. If it's something a little bit more inconsequential, like say a gunshot far away, maybe you want to set it lower in the priority. Volume. This one's pretty self-explanatory. So I'm gonna play the audio. Check out what it does when I lower the volume. Right? When I go up. It goes from 0 to 1. All right, pitch. Here, this one's interesting. You can increase or decrease the pitch of the audio, and it also speeds it up and slows it down accordingly. So you see it goes faster when it's pitched up and it goes slower when it's pitched down. Stereo pan pans the sound left or right. Check it out. To the right, to the left. Let's just keep it right there in the middle. All right, so spatial blend. This is a pretty important one. This one determines whether the sound is processed as 2D or 3D. So if the sound is 2D, you're gonna hear it No matter where you are in the world, you're gonna hear it the same. Relating to your distance to the item, you're gonna hear it more or less. So let's check it out. Right now it's set to 3D, and that means that the sound is far away, right? I'm on the other side of the room, so I hear it quieter because it's in 3D now. I'm gonna leave it in 3D because I wanna explain the 3D sound settings that we have down here. So reverb zone mix, it's just relating to the reverb zones we talked about earlier and tells you how much of the sound you're sending to the reverb zone. Let's go to the 3D sound settings. First, we have Doppler level. So Doppler basically means that how close you are to a sound changes its pitch. So if you've ever been standing still and you have an ambulance pass by really quickly, you notice that the sound of the siren pitches up in volume and then pitches down. So if the Doppler effect is higher, you're gonna have a much higher effect. And let's check out how that sounds. So as you can hear, as I run past the sound, the pitch goes up and down. Let's set it to 0 now and see how that affects it. It doesn't pitch up or down, no matter how close or how far away I am. So that is Doppler level. Okay, so spread. Spread means that when it's at 0, you're gonna hear it as a 3D stereo sound. And the closer you get to the top, you're gonna hear it as a multi-channel sound. Let's hear how that sounds. So you can definitely feel that. If you don't have headphones, it might be good to put them on to hear that. Volume Rolloff. This is an interesting one. This one relates to how close or how far away you are from the object itself. When you're very close, it's gonna be loud. And when you back away, the sound is gonna decrease. The volume roll-off is how quickly it's gonna roll off. And you can literally make any type of curve you want. You can have a logarithmic roll-off, which you can see it starts very high volume. And when you back away, it decreases very quickly. Let's hear how that sounds. So I'm very close and I back away and the sound drops off really quickly, right? You can also do a linear roll-off and look at how the curve changed to a line, a straight line. So we have the volume decreasing in a linear fashion. We can also do a custom roll-off and we can customize it in any way we want. Right now I have it set to dropping off quickly, and then as we get closer, it goes back up. Drops off around here, and when I get closer, it goes up. Then it drops off again, and when I get farther away, it goes back up again. So you can be really creative with this and do a lot of different things with this setting, custom roll-off. Okay, we have two settings left. Minimum distance and maximum distance. This relates to the distance you have to be at for the volume to be at its maximum point. So if you have a logarithmic roll-off, the minimum distance tells you how close you have to be for the sound to be at its fullest. So right now it's at 1. So you have to be really close for that sound to be at the top volume. If I increase that, you can see this little ball right here starts increasing and the minimum distance is less. So now I can get fairly close and the sound will be loud. Check it out. It's already loud. You see, and I'm not even on top of the item. The maximum distance starts dropping off, and when I pass the threshold of the maximum distance, it stays at a low level. So what the max distance tells us is how far away we need to be for the sound to stay at a steady low level. And that's it. Those are all the settings for the audio source in Unity. Thank you so much for watching. This was a super fun tutorial to make, and you can check out my previous tutorial on integrating your music into Unity Game Engine in my channel. So be sure to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoy this kind of content, and be on the lookout for more tutorials coming soon.